Space Patrol! High adventure in the wild, vast reaches of space. Missions of daring in the name of interplanetary justice. Travel into the future with Buzz Corey, Commander-in-Chief of the Space Patrol.
Space Patrol is brought to you by the delicious bite-sized checkerboard cereals. Wheat Chex, Rice Chex.
No matter where you go in time, Baccarati, I'm coming after you. Remember that.
Don't make me laugh, Corey. How are you going to get off the Earth? Out of this timeline, back to the 30th century? Or are you forgetting that there are no spaceships in the year 1692?
The great Prince Baccarati. His ego's so great he's blinded to his own vulnerability.
Why? All right, Corey. Get up! This is where you get off.
Stand by for exciting action on Baccarati and Black Magic in just one moment.
Hey, Space Patrollers, you want to hear something funny? Happened just the other morning to Cadet Happy as he was getting set to charge up with Chex. He opened the pantry, reached for the package, and...
Smoking rockets. I knew that Chex were power packed, but powerful enough to jump off the shelf? Wow. But then again, gang, you know that in every terrific tasting bite-sized Chex biscuit, you don't get just one power packed grain of wheat or rice, but more than 10 grains of power in every single Wheat Chex and Rice Chex. And you know, gang, it kind of figures, doesn't it, that if you got more power, that means more fun. And the fun starts right here. What's even spelled out for you? Look. C, that's for crispness. H, happiest tasting cereals in the universe. E, that's for that easy bite-size eating. X, that means extra terrific taste with milk or cream or fresh fruit. And right now, I'm going to have myself a big bowl of fun power. Jump Jupiter!
Well, gang, Hap finally got to eat his Chex. But he still doesn't know who rigged that trick package. Say, I think I'll have some.
Charge up with Chex, Captain Barkley, for more fun power. You too, Space Patrollers. Wheat Chex and Rice Chex.
A, B, C, D, E, F, G. Bite-sized Chex taste good to me. Bite-sized Chex. Wheat Chex, Rice Chex. Get your checkerboard cereal today.
This is a town in one of the original 13 colonies. It is the year 1692. These are dangerous days, for the people of this timeline have given way to mob hysteria as they seek out victims to persecute for the charge of witchcraft. Here, hidden in the forest near the town, is the 30th century battle cruiser of the Commander-in-Chief of the Space Patrol. Inside, the arrogant Prince Baccarati, having been rescued from the very trap he set for Buzz Corey and Cadet Happy, now finds himself and his loyal subject Barty once again in the custody of the Space Patrol. Meanwhile, Buzz and Happy have more important things to do than stand guard over two criminals. They are determined to keep a promise.
Hey, you know, Commander, must have taken good wife Martin weeks to make these clothes. It's no wonder she wants them back.
We have an even more important reason than that for returning the clothes, Happy.
Yeah, that's right. Ezekiel and Josiah Martin are still convinced that she was bewitched by us demons. And if they find out about these clothes... Well, they might even accuse her of witchcraft.
But I wouldn't even put it past that Ezekiel Martin to see that she was burned at the stake, even if she is his own wife.
Even yet it has not turned to butter.
Mayhap the cream was not right.
Mayhap the cream is bewitched. Bewitched, even like your own self.
Father, they are gone, vanished. Our Sunday meeting clothes, yours and mine.
Gone, are you certain?
I swear it, vanished as if by witchcraft.
Why have you stopped the churning, good wife? It is because you know something about the disappearance of the clothes? The demons themselves wore clothes like these. This belt was left here by one of them in this very house. What do you say to that, woman?
Please, Ezekiel. Your purge of witchcraft. It is superstition.
Then you dare not deny it. It was you who gave them the clothes, loomed by your own hands, to allow them to wander among us. You, woman, you disgraced us. You disgraced me.
Then she was bewitched as we thought.
No, Josiah, not merely bewitched. I am certain she's in league with the demons. I vow that she herself is a witch.
No, my husband. He cannot believe what you're saying.
As magistrate of this town, I vow to cleanse all the witches from our midst. You shall have a trial at the meeting house. You shall be purified by fire for your witchery.
Smoke and rockets, Commander. Those guys aren't kidding. My good wife doesn't stand a chance with the town magistrate and his son both testifying against her at the trial.
Hasten, Josiah, to the town crier. There's yet another trial to be held today. Hasten, Josiah.
Yes, Father. The demons. They've returned to the human form.
They shall not bring their witchcraft into this house any longer. Sorcery! It went from me as if by magic hands.
Ezekiel Martin, the sooner you get the idea of witchcraft and sorcery and black magic out of your mind, the better off you're going to be, because I'm not leaving here until you do.
Corey was a fool for going back to the town. It will serve him right if they capture him again.
Yes, but your highness, if Corey and the cadet do not return, we're helpless.
No, we won't be. Not after we get loose.
We gave our promise to Mrs. Martin that we would return these clothes.
And here they are. Good as new. Hardly a wrinkle. Well, not a new wrinkle, anyway.
Now, be honest. Does that sound like demons? Is it black magic to keep a promise?
Could be it is another tale. A false reason to return to plague us.
Look at it this way, Josiah. If we really were demons capable of black magic, couldn't we simply have conjured up the clothing?
Why, sure. Demons don't have to go around borrowing clothes. That is, if there were such a thing as witchcraft, which there isn't.
Lies, all lies. You say you're not wizards, yet you left the human form and go up into the wishing tree. Is that not witchcraft?
Oh, smoke and rockets. What's the use, Commander? Everything we do to try to convince them just gets us in deeper. They're as thick as Venus fog.
Venus? Father, they speak of the same body as the other one. Mayhap they tell the same story as the Black Falcon.
Baccarati? You mean he told you he came from Venus?
That and more. Fantastic tales of great ships that fly through the heavens and of time before ours, the 30th century.
Well, what do you know? Baccarati told the truth for once in his life.
What do you say to that?
Yes, it is true.
Then they are in league, the three of them.
Somehow, Ezekiel Martin, you're going to believe me. Now listen, and listen carefully.
Try. Your Highness, it's no use. It's impossible.
It's not impossible! Barty, I commanded you to break these bonds. Break them, or you'll regret it when I regain my throne of Venus. Break them!
Now, this ray gun I'm holding in my hand represents progress over your weapon, the blunderbuss. And the blunderbuss represents progress over the bow and arrow. Zeke, you can't halt progress, even with the superstition of witchcraft.
Now what do you say? Are you convinced? Are you finally convinced that we're telling the truth? You ought to feel lucky that you've got Mrs. Martin for a wife instead of trying to burn her at the stake for witchcraft.
I am convinced.
You're that, sir?
But never have I seen witchcraft demonstrated so thoroughly.
What?
You ask me to believe your word about a trip to the moon not being aided by sorcery.
No, Ezekiel. I won't ask you to be my word, not anymore. You're going to see it with your own eyes. You're going to see a spaceship. You're going to fly through the heavens in it.
No, no.
You're going to see the moon. If necessary, you're going to touch it. But you're going to believe me, Ezekiel Martin. You're going to release this poor woman from the death sentence of your superstition. You're all going, all three of you. Mrs. Martin. You trusted me before. I'm going to ask you to trust me once more. Now, don't be afraid. No harm will come to any of you, I promise.
Drop your weapons to the floor, or else my blunderbuss will silence you forever.
Smoking rocket, that funnel gun again.
You've all had your say, wizard. Now I'll have mine. I vow as town magistrate to rid this town of all witchery. You shall pay for your witchcraft at the stake.
Your test pilots, gang? How about this one? Started flying at 15. Now he's one of the country's outstanding record-breaking aviators. Meet Tony LeVere of Lockheed Aircraft.
Here's the Starfire, the Air Force Interceptor F-94C, designed by the Lockheed Aircraft Corporation, Burbank, California. Packing 48 rockets, the radar-controlled Starfire can take off, find the enemy, and attack day or night. Speed, more than 600 miles per hour.
Hello, I'm Tony LeVere, test pilot of the Starfire. Now I'd like to show you how we make a quick stop on a short runway.
Boy, it's sure a good feeling for a pilot to have that parachute pop out and slow down his plane like that.
You know, good health is important to a test pilot, and I have to stay in top condition. I get lots of rest and eat plenty of good food. That's why I like a good cereal for breakfast, like Rice Chex or Wheat Chex. They have real energy and they taste swell. Why don't you try them?
No other cereal, popped or flaked, contains so much nourishment in such concentrated bite-sized form. Rice Chex, Wheat Chex. Get some at your grocer's today. Gang, you charge up with Chex for more power, like Tony LeVere, Dan Darnell, and lots of other famous test pilots. Chex taste terrific and keep you ready for real action. Because in each bite-sized biscuit, you get not just one powerful grain of wheat or rice puffed up or spread out, but more than 10 grains in every single Rice Chex and Wheat Chex. And now, back to Space Patrol!
Use your heads. Think. And you'll know we told you the truth. Get their weapons, Father. I'll watch them.
Yes, Josiah.
On your toes, Hap. Right.
Move your foot.
What are you doing? What's going on?
All right, Josiah. Now, just like the commander said, you're going for a nice little ride in a spaceship. Does that look like a spaceship, or doesn't it?
Leviathan.
A what?
Yeah, truly, Father, it is a Leviathan, a monster of the deep.
Oh, what's the use?
All right, get aboard.
No, no, I will not be taken by Lucifer.
I said get aboard, up the ladder.
What's taking you so long, you fool?
I'm doing my best, Your Highness. Well, what's that? The outer hatch. Corey and the cadet must have returned.
Now, maybe the townspeople have found the ship. They are coming here to take us prisoners.
Well, the townspeople would be too afraid to come aboard, Your Highness. It must be Corian the cadet.
Yeah, yeah. It must be Corey. They have come back to blast off. We gotta get free.
Yeah, we got it.
Oh,
Here.
I hardly need to warn you not to try anything back there. I don't think you could fly this ship without us. Now, take it up 20,000 feet on repel array, then fire rockets. Stand by.
Standing by, sir.
Fire rockets. Repel array. Take a look out the viewport, CQ. Go ahead, look.
Black magic! We are transported above the clouds!
Truly, Father, you speak with the wisdom. We have fallen into the hands of Lucifer, the Black Angel himself.
20,000 feet, Commander.
Brace yourselves.
You might feel the acceleration a little.
Close ports.
Close ports.
Fire jets.
Fire jets!
Oh, Happy, you better go back aft and check Baccarati and Barney. We've left them alone much too long already.
Smoking rockets, that's right. I forgot all about them.
Keep trying, Your Highness. Keep trying. Look. Keep going.
Hurry.
Coming loose.
Well, enjoying the trip? Now, it's not that we don't trust you, gentlemen, but I think I'd better check your ropes.
Now Corey's gonna get the surprise of his life.
You've seen it as we approached, and now as our ship circles the moon, I'll pull in a little closer so you can get a good look at the surface.
What he says is true, Father. We are so close to the moon, we can nearly touch it.
Glory be. I vow it is truly a miracle.
Oh, what do you say, Ezekiel? Do you believe my story now?
You don't have to answer that, Ezekiel. It doesn't make any difference what you believe.
But right here, me, that gun, Corey.
Watch him.
What have you done with Happy?
That doesn't make any difference either. Get out of the sea. Quick!
Now, we're going back to Earth.
Back to Earth? I thought you were so anxious to leave.
I am, and Barty is too. But before we return to the 30th century, we're going to drop you and the others out.
In a few short minutes, the trip from the moon back to Earth is completed, and the evil Black Falcon proceeds to carry out his ruthless plan to abandon his prisoners.
All right, all of you, outside.
You heard him. This way.
No matter where you go, back in time, Baccarati. I'm coming after you, remember that.
Oh, don't make me laugh, Corey. How are you going to get off Earth? How are you going to get out of this timeline? How are you going to get back to the 30th century? Or are you forgetting that there were no spaceships in the year 1692?
The great Prince Baccarati. His ego is so great that he's blinded to his own vulnerability.
Why, don't! All right, Corey, get out! This is where you're gonna get out.
All right, hurry. How are you next? Stand over. All right, Corey, down the ladder. Better?
All right, all of you. Move away from the ship. Come on! That's better. All right, Corey. Let me see you get out of this. Come on, Barty.
Come
do not recognize this forest, Father. I've never been here before. Truly, we are lost.
You swore that no harm would come to us.
No harm has come to you yet.
This is your responsibility, you and your black magic.
If we could use black magic, do you think we'd let ourselves get in a spot like this?
Don't be afraid. You won't be harmed.
We better get back a little, Commander. There. About the blast off, we might get caught in a rocket blast.
There isn't going to be a rocket blast, Happy.
All right, fire rocket.
There must be something wrong.
Oh, you fool, I'll try it.
I don't understand it. The ship was flying perfectly before.
Corey must have done something to the ship. Come on.
I needled Baccarati into taking a swing at me. And I fell directly under the instrument panel, and I pulled this out.
The transistor. The rockets won't fire without it.
Quick, get over there in a group, all of you.
All right, Corey. I'm on to your trick. What have you done to this? Corey, where are you?
Right here, Baccarati.
Woman, how dare you?
He dares because he knows more about the truth than you or your son.
But what do we do now, Commander?
Now, Happy, I think it's time to return these people to their home.
Yeah, but Commander, what about...
Now, Happy.
Oh, yes.
Come on, Cordy.
Matter of minutes, the huge battle cruiser rises from the surface of Earth and is airborne, swiftly carrying its passengers back to the forest surrounding the colonists' town. Another few minutes, and the Terra 5 settles slowly to Earth on repeller ray.
Now, look, fellas, I know we kind of roughed you up a little bit, but, well, surely you must believe that we're telling the truth now. We're not demons, honest. Otherwise, we wouldn't have brought you back home, would we? Well, look, anyway, please don't cause any trouble for Mrs. Martin. You promise?
All right, dear, you're free to go home now, all of you. I'm sorry for the trouble we've caused you.
Go.
Well, Commander?
Yes, sir.
Is that all you're going to say to them?
Well, don't you think we've said enough?
Yeah, but Commander, I still don't think they believe us. I still think that Ezekiel and Josiah still believe in witchcraft and will think of what might happen to Mrs. Martin.
Happy, I said that we wouldn't leave here until we were sure that she'd be safe. And we're not. Up the ladder.
Well, but sir... Yes, sir.
I, for one, do not believe in all this. Truly, our belief in witchcraft was manifested today, beyond all doubt.
It was a trick to make us think we were flying through the air to the moon. We're well rid of the demons now, except for one.
I will hasten to the town square. There's no wizards now to prevent it.
I wouldn't be too sure of that, Josiah.
The voice. The wizards are gone, but... the voice remains to plague us.
Ezekiel Martin, listen to me.
Where's the voice coming from?
The box. The voice is coming from the box again.
I have some words of advice for you, Ezekiel. And you too, Josiah. You had better listen carefully.
Oh, Mother, I beg of you, take the box away. Do not bring it near me. Take it away. As long as you persist in your belief of witchcraft, remember this. If, as you say, your wife is bewitched, then so are you. If, as you insist, your trip to the moon was merely a spell cast upon you by Lucifer, then heed this warning. Should your townspeople learn of your hallucination, they will turn upon you and accuse you of black magic. You dare not tell them of your experience, or you'll commit yourself to the stake. Never forget, Ezekiel Martin, that you're equally as guilty of witchcraft as your wife. If you're innocent, then so is she. For your experiences have been the same. Accuse good wife Martin of witchcraft, and you accuse yourself.
Do you think it'll work, sir?
I think it already has, Happy.
Josiah, lend your strong arm to the mother churn. Help your mother. Can't you see she's tired? Josiah, obey me. I am your father. In the future, you'll have more time to help your mother with the chores. You won't be always chasing witches.
Yes, Father.
My good woman, perhaps it is, as you say. The cream was not ripe for churning.
Close ports.
Close ports. Fire jets. Fire jets. Up ship and away.
In just a moment, a preview of next week's exciting Space Patrol adventure, which will be brought to you by Nestle's Ever Ready, the instant cocoa, and famous Nestle's chocolate bars.
Hi, Space Patrollers. You know, whether I go to the moon or the planets, forward or backward in time, I always head for the galley when I get home. That's so I can have a big, delicious cup of Nestle's Ever Ready cocoa. I sure go for that sensational Nestle's chocolate bar flavor. The wonderful taste that's so chocolatey rich. It's a great energy booster, too. Really gives you a charge. I sure like the way you can make it in an instant. Now, look. Just put one, two, three spoonfuls in the cup. Add the hot water. And there it is. There's nothing to add. Because whole milk and sugar are already in it. And Nestle's Ever Ready cocoa is a perfect way to start your day and finish it. So why don't you ask Mom to get this bright red and yellow can of Nestle's Ever Ready? Well, now I think I'll have my Nestle's cocoa. How about you?
And now, a scene from next week's exciting adventure. A Christmas present for Happy.
Robbie, now listen. I'm leaving everything up to you. I don't care what you have to do, but get rid of Happy. No, not for good. Just for one day. I don't want him around here on Christmas. Why not? Well, just wait and see.
Be sure to be with us to see what Christmas in the 30th century is like, to meet Happy's mother and father for the very first time, and to see what complications arise out of Buzz's desire to produce a Christmas present for Happy. Next week on Space Patrol. Here today by the bite-sized cereals in the red and white checkerboard packages. Wheat Chex, Rice Chex.
Stu Irwin stars on ABC Television.